I'd
like to stand up. I'd stand up. So okay. I'm free to do.
Okay, because your back is hurting.
Yes, yes.
Okay. All right.
I have some, you know, eggs in back, so sometimes I need to stand up and, you know, look over you.
Okay. So questions from the press, please.
And please identify yourself.
Yes, please, your name and your... Go ahead, yes. Yes, Anthony. Oh, sorry, I didn't see. Yeah, please, Anthony, come on up.
Can you come to here?
Yeah.
Please.
Anthony Rowley, Singapore Business Times. Governor, there's obviously going to be enormous pressure on the labour market in Tokyo, not only for the Olympic Games, but also for the infrastructure projects.
Yes, sure.
And there's going to be pressure on wages too. What ideas do you have to overcome this? I mean, and do those include possibly immigration or temporary immigration in order to solve what is obviously going to be a very big problem?
Yes. Thank you, Bennett, for your question. You know, this labour shortage is... one of the headache of mine, and we have a kind of system to invite the workers as trainees for the construction anything. So for example, if I remember correctly, the period was limited to, for example, 2 or 3 years. Now we can do that 5 years. So this is one of the measures. So we'll invite the people who want to, you know, come to work with us and to make money, and we welcome them. Okay?
Next. Okay. Yes, Hasegawa-san, dozo.
My name is Hasegawa from Radio Nikkei. Regarding on energy, renewable energy policy, do you have any intention to operate or build hydrogen supplying infrastructure by yourself?
We are planning to make Tokyo a model case, showcase for the hydrogen, future hydrogen society. So we are closely working with industries who can provide with technologies and, to have a hydrogen energy, there are many, many ways and measures. And we are having a big team, including academics, researchers, engineers, corporations, and also national governments. And we will ask these industries to make big, innovations and will make maximum use of them. And if it need be, in case, I'll think about subsidize if it's possible.
Okay. Any more questions from the press? Yes, please go ahead.
Nishimura with Hokkaido Shimbun newspaper. I think the transportation system in Tokyo is too complicated for foreign visitors, and you have two kind of subway company, which are Tokyo Metro and Toei. And do you have any specific idea to integrate the two companies until Tokyo Olympic 2020?
You know, I said that we have to improve the Tokyo transportation system. I said, what I mean is, if you are a user of any kind of public transportation systems, suppose from here to go to Haneda Airport, how can you go there? Metro or any kind of railway or bus or taxi is very easy. So this kind of, the combination is not so good. So I'd like to improve that. But two metros are not such a vital problem. Now you have PASMO, Suica cards. Or is that you can go everywhere? This is really good innovation. When I was young, when I go to London, living in Paris, how to ride on the bus? It's very hard. Each time I have to each, you know, cities, I lived so, so many cities in Europe. And each time, for example, in Switzerland, in Geneva, in Zurich, two cities, they have a different system of bus, you know, paying system. So the German-speaking Swiss cannot understand my French-speaking Geneva, the system. But now, with this card, you can go everywhere. So the this is not a vital problem. So the another problem is, you know, the general view of future transportation system. So the policy should be made by which kind of priorities? I have no priority to combine two railway metro system into one. I have many, many other priority changes, reforms that I have to do. Okay?
Okay, go ahead. Yes, please. Yeah. I've
got it. En français? No.
Yeah, en français.
No? Ça va, ça va, ça va.
Maybe.
You have time. No problem.
Hi, Andy Klein, WCN-TV.com. Asian financial hubs typically have a pretty good competency of the English language.
Yes.
So is there any plan or ambition to match that with Tokyo?
Yeah, you know, the my policy is from Singapore back to Tokyo, any kind of hub, you know, the this kind of financial market. So, for example, as far as Tokyo government is concerned, if you or if some foreign entrepreneur who cannot speak Japanese at all can make companies very easily, you can write all papers in English, no problem. And so-called one-stop service. You go to my office, I mean Tokyo government office, everything is done on that system. We are moving in that direction. So, of course, the not only English, multi-language response is now we are preparing. So anyway, we will make our society, you know, to English understood very, very easily. This is one of the measures that I made.
Okay, great. Okay, Joel, and then Ueno-san in the back. Yes. So Joel first, and then Ueno-san.
Yes. Wait a every time you ask me to speak French, so I'll do a short sentence.
Okay.
Bonjour, my name is Joël Lejean from RTL France. Les Jeux Olympiques, c'est l'occasion d'avoir une visibilité francophone.
Sure.
Il va y avoir les Jeux de la francophonie à Abidjan. Est-ce que vous allez inviter des gens du Japon à Abidjan en 2017, par exemple, en Côte d'Ivoire? Okay, in English now. Olympics. Olympics is an occasion for the people to remember that the French language is the language of the Olympic movement. And I wanted to ask you, what are you going to do to sustain this in the Tokyo Olympic Games? We talk about signals and things, but what else are you going to do? And for example, are you going, as Tokyo is going to be the welcoming city of the Olympic Games, where French should be there also appearing, are you planning to send people from Tokyo to the Jeux de la Francophonie, the Francophonie Games, which is to happen in 2017 in Abidjan, Côte d'Ivoire. Thank you.
Merci. Vous avez posé les bonnes questions, mais il faudrait que je parle en français, en anglais, oui. I know. Sorry, any language. First of all, I asked the your embassy here in Tokyo to provide is the volunteer people who are francophone, who can speak French. And also, I will prepare Japanese volunteers who can speak French. And as you know very well, the first language of IOC is French. The second is English, and the third is the destination, you know, the hosting cities. So the to Abidjan and any kind of cities that you would recommend, I'm ready to go if it's necessary. But of course, not only English-speaking people, but also the vast population of Francophone and Espanol also. So the I'd like to make maximum use of this occasion of 2020 Games to ask the Japanese people, not only younger people, but aged persons, to learn at least English, and if possible, French or Chinese or Korean, any languages. And I will provide, subsidize to these elder persons who have the courage to learn again English. Because when I was in the Sochi Olympic Games and the closing ceremony, you know, the inside the venues, it's okay that there are many, many volunteers who can speak English. But outside these venues, souvenir shops, you have to make yourself understood in solely in Russian. Even 1, 2, 3, and 3 cannot be understood. So this is the experience I drew from Sochi Olympic Games. But at least you go to Asakusa, you go to any place that you like. At least 1, 2, 3 is okay, right? So in the coming years, maybe under 3.
What do you plan?
Je vais donner un peu de soutien pour la communauté qui voudrait bien. Vous savez, avoir l'école pour les conversations anglaises, françaises, n'importe. So I give some subsidies to these people who really want to, you know, learn foreign languages. Okay?
Okay, thank you. So Ueno-san, and then the gentleman over here. And then why don't you go ahead? Yeah. Yes,
Dozo.
Please. So 1, 2, 3, yeah.
Anyway, time is running out, so the quick question and quick response, okay?
Quick
hello.
Yes.
We are TV show Sekai Banzuke. Hi. World ranking from Nippon Television.
Hi.
I am Yukio Ueno.
Yes.
What would you like to make the Tokyo Olympic? Please answer in a word.
One word?
Please answer in a word.
One word.
Tokyo, number one city of the world.
Is that
and
okay?
The 2020 Olympic and Paralympic Games, the best games ever.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Short and sweet. Okay, please. Yes, go ahead.
Andy Staples, Economist Corporate Network. You haven't mentioned anything about the special economic zone, and I wonder if you could give us some idea of where you are with those discussions. Thank you.
Yes. You know, the make use of the national strategic special zone, and the so that, for example, as I mentioned, the Toranomon Hills area, we have three kinds of roads, streets. One is the Tokyo Metropolitan Roads, and there is a national road, and the other is Minato World Roads. So we can deregulate anything that concerns our properties, but national government and Minato World, I have no right to intervene. So I will use this special district ideas to ask government why national government should follow us, and same kind of thing. And Tokyo financial, the center, global financial center ideas, we need to deregulate many, many things in order that foreign entrepreneur bankers can work easily in Tokyo. Then I'd ask to the national government to deregulate, because this is our special district. And number of special districts, now 9 districts of the 9 wards, but we will increase. So I ask to every cities, towns, communities to Tokyo, if really you want to do something, but if national government, make some obstacles to your ideas, please tell me. And I'll ask the government to change your district special district. So in order that you can do anything that you like. So I'm close links with government, and we are moving forward in that direction. So there is no problem at all.
Okay. Yes, please. Go ahead. Yes.
Elaine Lee is from Reuters News Agency. In the Tokyo Olympic candidature, yes, English is my native language, candidature file, they pledged a compact Olympics within 8 kilometers. They pledged an Olympics that would be a downtown Olympics, and they pledged an Olympics, you know, that would preserve and enhance the environment. Well, there are many different movements that seem to go against this promise by which Tokyo won the Olympics, moving venues outside of Tokyo 25, 30 kilometers away. And, of course, the problem of the Olympic Stadium, the canoe in Nishikasai. I mean, this is not great for the environment. How do you reconcile this reality that is developing with the promises with which Tokyo won the Games? Thank you.
Thank you very much. Very good question. You know, you just mentioned the Kasai canoe venues. This is, you know, the direction that I said is a very good one, because this make the environment, you know, they keep the environment as it is. So there is no problem. But when they say compact, you know, you said the eight kilometers. What means 8 kilometers? From the village to the venues, you know, approximately 30 minutes is the maximum. But even if one venue, basketball, volleyball, anything, is 50 kilometers far away from the village, if you have the transportation system, we can bring the athlete 100 kilometers an hour. You can bring them in a half an hour, no problem at all. So we make the special lane for the Olympic lane, for example. But most important thing, madam, is compact. Not only this kind of distance, but budget, cost. Cost should be compact. This should not be forgotten. Why IOC, Mr. Bach of the chairman, and Mr. Gout, vice chairman, did agree fully with me, is they have to make, financially speaking, Olympic Games compact. If not, no city will raise hand in the coming years. It's impossible. For example, they say, of course, there are many, many big responsibilities for the people who beat it. You know, of course, I understand you say very good things to invite the people and, you know, win such a severe race. But I am a man with Mr. Mori to implement, to realize really wonderful Olympic Games. So very severely, I checked everything. Impossible. You said, for example, you know, 1 billion, for example, or 10 million yen, right? Or 10 million. Even if it's double or triple, it's something. 10 times more, 20 times more, 50 times more. I'm not exaggerating. Can you understand that? Can you persuade the voters, taxpayers, to pay this kind of money? So my point is, I am a close, you know, we have the close, you know, consultation with National Federation, International Federation, IOC, and we are working together to make 2020 Games, you know, the wonderful and sustainable. Sustainability is very, very important key words. And, you know, maybe if you live in Tokyo, you know the Komaza Olympic Games. That's marvelous. This is a positive legacy. And I gather in London that you just opened the new you know, public places for the you know, the London Olympic legacy. This is the case. But if you pay such an amount of money and after the games you abolish everything, who can understand that? And time is coming out, so the we are not this conference, but you know the our plan for the Olympic Games. So we are working very hard in order that we have the consensus, right? It's okay.
Did that answer your question?
Okay.
Okay. Great. Okay. We have two minutes.
Okay. Yes. Yeah,
until
one.
3 o'clock. That's just one more question. Okay. Please go ahead. Yes.
Hello, my name is Harumi Ozawa from AFP News Agency. Yes. You mentioned that the kind of diplomacy only Tokyo can do. And how confident are you to play the role to mediate Prime Minister Abe and his South Korean and Chinese counterparts, and also especially with South Korea? How can you play the role of mediating, especially in light of the comfort women issue? Thank you.
You know, from the outset, you know, I have no intention to play the mediate role between the two national governments. And I was not special envoy by the prime minister. My intention is we have to keep national interest. And I don't like to make myself some obstacles against our national governments. So I'm very careful not to, you know, do this kind of, you know, the harm in the sense of national interest. So before going to Beijing, before going to Seoul, I went to Prime Minister's office, and we are very friends, Mr. Abe and myself. So we frankly, you know, discussed, and this is your intention. And he said, well, convey my message to Chinese leader, to South Korean leader, well, I'll do that. And also knowing that I'm a very close friend of Mr. Abe, Chinese and South Korean governments say everything that they like, very severe estimation of Abe's administration. So on my return back to, you know, Beijing, I said directly to Mr. Abe, your estimation is so low, and, you know, the Chinese government is so severely critical to you. This is a situation that you are surrounded. This I convened. My point is I'm doing city diplomacy. And city-to-city talks, dialogues, people-to-people, you know, the dialogues, will help enhance the good relationships. And as far as these very touchy issues, you know, I just spoke everything about Seoul National Universities. So my point is very shortly, especially, you know, not only Japan, South Korea and China, we have to separate clearly academism from politics. This is a point. Politics should be, you know, academism should be interpreted politically, should not be interpreted politically. So I said to the scholars, you study, you know, the jointly with Chinese scholars, Japanese scholars, Korean scholars, and make facts, you know, the facts-based historical studies, then you can say anything. But I am a political leader, so what I'll say now is somewhat different from when I was professor of Tokyo University. So this should be very bad thing about that is about our three countries, even in Japan, even in South Korea, and especially in China, academism is not entirely separated from politics. This is a problem. Okay,
thank you so much. We've run out of time. Really, really appreciate you coming today.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed.
And we have our tradition of the club to give you a 1-year honorary member. Please come again.
Thank you very much.
Okay, and everyone, can you please stay seated until Masuzoe-san leaves? Please stay seated. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. Please invite me again in sometimes.
We will for sure.
Yeah. Thank you very much indeed.